All right, ladies and gentlemen, we are back of our little pre-game of our own here with Artosis and myself as we talk about Creator Prime going up against Sting in the next map, Cloud Kingdom. So far, Creator Prime's played a very solid defensive style, unbreakable, untouchable. Sting has gone from one extreme to the other, but what does he do on Cloud, Artosis?
He played Cloud in the last series against First, and this is actually the map that he hit a command center on, and it's counterintuitive to hide here, as you said, Apollo, because it's kind of like the map doesn't feel that big when you've played it a lot, so it feels like it should be easy to find. I don't think we're going to see that here from him. He's already tried that in this series. I'm going to go out and say Sting is going to go Cloaked Banshee.
Cloaked Banshee, and yes. Could I top that and say, you know, what do you think the fallout would be from that? Would it be a macro fallout? Would it be continued follow-up? Okay, 1-1-1.
Yeah, I would say definitely you'll throw down a couple racks and just all in, all the way, because at this point, I mean, that last game, he got a great start macro-wise and still couldn't finish it off, so let's see a Cloaked Banshee in a 1-1-1 Sting.
All right, let's do it, guys. Let's load in to Cloud Kingdom. And in Clown Kingdom, we are, as we now are witnessing, the third map between Creator Prime and, of course, his opponent. But let's go ahead and talk about our opponent here. Spawning in the top right, the blue Protoss, the unbreakable Protoss. It is Creator Prime.
Yes, indeed, the unbreakable Protoss, who apparently I insulted by trying to think of the hardest thing I could, which is diamonds, but is also, like, a league not fit for a pro gamer. Alright, so in the bottom left, we have our red Terran player. He's going to have to win a game pretty soon here, or, well, he's going to be out. It is Sting.
And I definitely urge anybody that wants to see how to beat Creator and how someone has beaten him recently is to go check out the up and down matches from the GSL where Supernova actually did beat him, and I think it was 2-0, if I'm not mistaken. I think they may have played twice. I'm not sure if that's true or not.
Yeah, it was. I do believe it was a 2-0 for Supernova.
Wow.
So
that's impressive. Supernova, a great Terran player, demonstrating how to pick apart a solid Protoss player. But is Sting going to be able to do the same thing?
Well, I don't know, man, because Supernova is kind of like the OG of killing Protosses for Terran. So, I mean, that's like how he made his name back in Code 8. It was back when PVT was really hard, like it feels right now watching Creator. He was the guy that was actually showing Terrans how to do it. But Sting, he's got to do something crazy here, and he is getting that quick gas. So I really think that that prediction is going to come true here. Cloak Banshee fell.
Seems like it very well could be. And SCV is going to block off with a supply depot. Once again, keeping the options away from Creator Prime, who has played twice already against a block off like this. The first time it was super aggression, this time, or the previous time, sorry, was of course going into that crazy macro style play. Double command center, but this time with the gas coming down, the options are open and it could be, or definitely should be, aggression.
Yep. Well, Creator did scout very quickly this game. So, you know, he realizes that this is kind of a little bit of a smaller map. Maybe he can get over there and see what's going on. But very smart here of Sting to wall in so quickly. Not going to allow him to see what's actually going on.
Factory's coming down. Let's see if he's going to get that second gas in a few seconds' time. Unfortunately, as we said, Creator's got no indication and has to play pretty much blind until the observers come out, unless he gets some kind of key information that would only come through Sting's mistakes. Having Marines out of position, supply depot down. We do have a tech lab on the barracks, though, initially.
Oh, that's interesting. Look at that, a tech lab on the barracks and a quick factory here. Okay, so could we be seeing...
Is it like a simple Road of Hellion play, right?
It could be, yeah, that's kind of a dated build as well. Sting really uses a lot of stuff that's been out of the metagame a while.
And I suppose he could get a stopper with this as well, with the additional the gas he's going to back up. But with consistent rotor production, it will slow it down quite a bit. So unless he takes a second gas, I feel that it will just be a command center on the low ground following this top. He could get a lot of damage done because Marauders and Hellions early on, especially against a guy that's rushing straight up the Robo, he has very few units out there, especially if the Zealot and Stalker was to get trapped here.
Yeah, if he actually were to lose this Stalker, which he might, the Concussive Shells are almost done. Will he get it? No, the Zealot coming up. And actually, Creator pushing very adeptly there and just gets his Stalker out in time. That was clutch by Creator not to lose that Stalker.
And he still has, well, he doesn't know if this is a double barracks down, if there's Hellions involved. The probe is hidden on the natural, very smart probe on the natural to see if the expansion's going to follow it down. We do have a little bit of a later starport coming down, so we are going to see a medivac to aid this out, and the push will continue. Crater Prime has gateways coming down instead of the robo, and he, oh my god, he canceled his Nexus too. What a smart, smart decision to do.
Yeah, that was brilliant. That was beautiful, and in fact, he canceled his Robo, and he's just going to go for five gates here. That's a little bit surprising. Oh my god, look at this. He's just going to do a huge counterattack, hold his ramp with some Force Fields and Stalker Micro, and do a counter.
Oh, look at this. Creator Prime waiting for these units to come there. Force Field does just delay and extend his time as the warp gates are almost ready. There is not another Force Field available. It's going to have to take a couple more seconds, but Sting backs off. The medivac should be on its way, or it's only just now started, actually. But with five gateways, it can simply be a great defense. Warping through Zealots, go straight for the mineral line. It could even be that.
Yeah, this is actually something that's going to catch Sting off guard. I didn't expect Creator to do this. You know, he already had his Robo on the way. If you just let that finish and get an Immortal, you can easily take your natural and not even be behind. But, oh my god, this was a mistake right here. Creator getting caught by those concussive shells. And these Stalkers are going to go down in a matter of seconds.
Oh wow, that's exactly what Sting needs. And now the Hellions will chase these down. Great Force Field to hold on. But with the medivac coming, he's actually just going to elevate into the main base. And I think Creator thought he was in a position where he can turn the tide. And as you actually see at the south side, a Sentry and Zealot warped in as he moved out. He was ready to launch the counterattack. And, well, Sting was like, yes, free units, and now he's going to turn this around.
Yeah, the one thing you cannot do in a situation like this is lose free units, and that's the one thing that Creator did, so I like Sting's spot right now, but those are some nice forces. No, not quite nice enough. If he had actually trapped those Marauders, he could have killed them, but as is, they're microing very well against Creator right now.
And Creator's got a lot of Zealots here, and they just don't die. And oh, nice little pickup there. Gonna move around to the main base, try to get it into the mineral line. Stalker is already there to try to help out. More units get warped in, and Creator's gonna launch his attack here, Autosis. And is Sting gonna be ready for it? Because he's playing dancing production facilities in the main base.
Well, you know, he's got the wall in, which is pretty good. He is going to start a bunker, but that's going to be just a little bit too late for him. And he is going to go back and actually drop in behind Creator's mineral line here. And the probe's actually going to have to come up, but there's two Hellions in there. So Sting's drop actually doing some great damage.
Yeah, door down here, and they will pick up Valvacella and continue to do even more damage with two Marauders and a Hellion. Great drop, but at the same time, is he going to be able to hold his main base? The bunker is so close. SMBs have to get there to repair. Otherwise, the front wall will just be down so simply.
Well, it looks like he is absolutely going to break down this depot. Wait a minute, the SCV's coming up, and he is not targeting any of those repairing SCVs down, not throwing down any force fields either. Instead, getting rid of that bunker very quickly. Well done, a nice Guardian Shield as well. The SCV is struggling to try to keep depots alive, and Creator has broken the front.
Oh my god, what are we seeing here? Creator Prime is only at 10 probes, so if we do see Sting hold on, he's in great shape, but he's about to lose a lot of SCVs at the same time. The Stalkers are on top of the Marauder and Marines, and I don't think he can do anything else here. The Medivacs is going to fall. This is a very, very tense moment.
Indeed it is, and it looks like Creator may have enough Stalkers here just to win the game off of them alone. A couple more Zealots going up, and a few sentries left over. Oh my god, Creator, even after losing all those units and all those probes, wins the game. GG. Really impressive play there by Creator to take that down.
He just, everything that happens, He just doesn't seem to lose. The decisions are perfect. The fights are awesome. I guess that was one little bit of a mistake in the middle of the map as we called it out with the engagements. But aside from that, the complete strategy mapped out here by Creator worked exactly to a T. And that sets him up 3-0.
Well, 3-0. Luckily for Sting, the best map for TVP is coming up next. It's going to be Antigua Shipyard.
Yeah, it's a great map. Talk about that a little bit more in just a few moments' time. So thank you for watching the TSL4. Say thank you to Razer. Say thank you to Twitch TV. Of course, they've made this very much so possible. Stay tuned, guys. We'll be right back.